That's my cue. All right. Hey, good morning. Good morning. Welcome here, Studio CPCBA. It's good to have you all here with us. For a closed church, we've already had a very busy morning, right? 9:30, we were here. We had a congregational meeting. I'll talk a little bit about that. Thank you, Tim, for that wonderful concert that's been going on. So there is so much going on here, even when we're sadly not together. So to that, let's begin the day. A welcome to all of you. Welcome to our visitors who are checking in from all kinds of different places. Welcome to all of you, so faithful and joining us here this morning. So good morning to you and welcome to church this morning. Our congregational meeting this morning, we did meet and we were presented with a slate of elders and deacons and some other positions. The voting is still open. If you go to the church website, you'll find a link in the menu that will take you to a Google form where you can continue to cast your vote. And so if you were not able to join us this morning, for whatever reason, please go to that link on the menu and vote. The voting will be open until about 11, and then we'll tally the results, and Pastor Donna will share that with you before the end of the service. So please check that link on the website, cast your vote, and we'll collect those and make that announcement. Even as our doors and our sanctuary empty, we are still looking for ways to celebrate. And June is our traditional strawberry festival, and we are going to do it again. So here's what you need to put in your mind and pen to paper, and that is we are collecting strawberry recipes. If you've got a favorite strawberry recipe, I know ours is strawberry pretzel salad. We will certainly be submitting that for your wonderful enjoyment. But if you have a special strawberry recipe, please collect those. Send that recipe. There's a recipe link that you can use, rsvpcpcba@gmail.com, to send us your recipe, and then we'll be sharing those out, and you can make a special strawberry something for June 14th. So June 14th's on your calendar. By then, send us a strawberry recipe, something that we can make that's extraordinary with strawberries, and we will all enjoy them together virtually on June 14th. So be thinking about that. Finally, as we leave here again, thank you for your generosity. Continue to give to support our programming here. We are just so thankful for that and all the different ways that you're able to do that, from clicking on our buttons to sending us a check to making sure that our offerings are here and supporting the programming that we do. So thank you all for being here. It is a blessed Sunday. Spring is here and sprung, and so let us begin worship together.
Good morning. I greet you in the name of the living, loving God, and in the name of the risen Christ, who said, wherever there are two or three gathered together in my name, I am there among you. And so, friends, wherever you are, how many are there with you, we are all gathered together here in Jesus' name to worship the Lord our God. So, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
For the beauty of the earth, for the glory of the skies, for the love which from our birth over and around us lies, Lord of all, to thee we raise this our hymn of grateful praise. For the joy of human love, brother, sister, parent, child, friends on earth and friends above, local, gentle thought and mild, Lord of all, to thee we raise this our gift of faithful grace. For thyself best gift give I,
gather together on this day to offer our grateful hearts, our grateful praise to God. And we also gather together needing a little grace these days. And so, friends, let us gather together our hearts and offer them to God in the prayer of confession. Let us pray. Gracious God, your love is greater than anything we can imagine. Yet sometimes we look for love in all the wrong places, and we are left feeling empty. Forgive us for turning away from you. Help us to remember your relentless love for us, and to give us the depth, strength, and courage to love others well. Amen. The mercy of our God is from everlasting to everlasting. It never runs out, and it never quits. There is enough for you and for me and for all who believe. So friends, believe this, the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. I now invite the children to gather together for children's time. Good morning, girls and boys. So good to be with you this morning for time with children. So today, I want to tell you and show you something, and it's about love. So here's the color page that I have on the website for you, so hopefully you can print that off and put a little crayon or a pencil to the page and bring it alive. So this is my color page of love. You can see the words, and you can also see pictures that help us know what love is. But I have something else to show you. What is this? This is called a tape measure. Maybe you have seen one at your house. It's used to measure things. So I wanted to measure what, I wanted to measure love. So let's start off and see what we can do here. And Mr. Brian's gonna come help me. He's gonna help me measure. All right, so we're gonna measure this page. First of all, turn so they can see you. All right, so how many inches is that?
It's 11 inches.
11 inches, okay. You can put that down. Let's see. How about we measure the chair? How tall is the chair?
It's 23 inches.
23 inches, okay. Let's see. Where else could we measure? Let's measure the pulpit. See how tall the pulpit is. Okay.
51 inches.
51 inches, okay. Let's see. Let's measure Mr. Brian. Let's see how tall you are. 73 inches. Woo!
Wow.
You grew. So we can measure a lot of different things, but how do we measure God's love, I wonder? Well, we could start by trying to measure the church. Let's see. Let's see how we can stretch it out. Stretch it out. Let's see how much we can measure. Well, that's 300 inches, but it still doesn't measure the whole church, does it? So it's kind of like with God's love. We can't measure it, girls and boys. We don't have a tape measure big enough for it because God's love is so big and so great that it fills this church and fills this world. And here's the good news for today. Not only is it big, but God's love is small enough to fit right here in our hearts. So you can carry it with you wherever you go. It's pretty cool, huh? Thanks for your help. So let's end, girls and boys, where we started, where we always like to end, and that is with a word of prayer. So let us pray. Put your hands up high, clap them together, bring them down over your eyes, close your eyes, open your mouths, and repeat after me. Dear God,
thank you
for your love,
which is big enough
for the whole world,
and small enough
for our hearts. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, girls and boys. And now I'd like to introduce to you, the next person you're going to see on the screen is Laura Bentley, and she's our new Director of Faith Formation. And I want you to see her face and get to know her. She's going to be doing our prayer and our scripture reading. And pretty soon, hopefully sometime, you're going to be able to see her here in church. But for now, enjoy seeing her and hearing her reading the scripture for us.
Let us pray. God of our lives, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear what you have to say to us today. Amen. Scripture reading this morning comes from John chapter 14, verses 15 through 23. This is Jesus speaking. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees the Spirit nor knows the Spirit. You know the Spirit because he abides with you, and the Spirit will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. Judas, not Iscariot, said to him, Lord, how is it that you will reveal yourself to us and not to the world? Jesus answered him, those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Speak, Lord, speak a word. Speak a word of truth. Speak a word of power. Speak a word of love. Speak, Lord, for your people are listening. In Jesus' name, amen. When I was a young girl in school, one of my favorite days of the week was show and tell day. I loved to bring in something special from home and share it with my friends at school. So I wasn't surprised when my son Christian, in preschool, his favorite day was show and tell day too. And his day was Wednesday, and he couldn't wait until Wednesday to be able to bring in a special toy from home and share it with his friends. And so one day, it was a Monday, and I was picking him up from preschool, and his teacher said, Christian did not have a good day. So I was preparing in my mind that I was going to have a consequence, and I was going to have to take away the trip to the ice cream parlor that we had planned for after school that day. So I asked the teacher, well, what did he do? And she pulled out his toy truck from her bag, and she said, Christian brought this in today. Today is Monday. It is not Wednesday. This was not his show and tell day. I said, oh, okay, thank you. I'll talk with him about that. Put the truck back in my purse. And on the way home, I asked Christian, I said, so buddy, what happened today? And he said, Mom, I know. I just was so excited. I couldn't wait. I had to bring in my truck to show my friends. I really wanted them to see it. And I said, I understand, I'll help you remember. And I gave him a hug, and we went to get ice cream. I like to think that Jesus would have done the same. Because Jesus was a show-and-tell kind of guy. In our gospel lesson for today, we read that Jesus is telling his disciples something really important. He says, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father. And I will love them and reveal myself to them. So in this short scripture passage that Laura read for us today, 9 verses, the word love appeared 6 times. In the Gospel of John, the word love appears 57 times. So the Gospel of John, if you would summarize it in one word, you would say it's love, right? Easy to remember. When I was a graduate student at Vanderbilt, one of the hardest things I had to do was to take my 400-page dissertation and condense it to a 3-minute presentation. It was so hard. I can't imagine condensing it to one word. Well, this past week, as I was thinking about how can we do this online worship creatively, looking for some new ideas, because you're experiencing it differently on TV than you did here in the sanctuary. So I came upon this website, and this pastor's name, he was called the Tattoo Preacher, and he had a 30-second sermon. I thought, wow, that's interesting, right? So let me take a look. So the one that I read was called Love Lenses, and it goes like this. One of the greatest tragedies in life is for the Bible to be interpreted by people who are not in love. When my need to appear right is greater than my desire to display God's love, I will inevitably treat people with judgment, disrespect, and harshness. The Old Testament is filled with so many disasters that it is not hard to pick up an angry approach to life or ministry. That is, until you consider Jesus. Love changes everything. Changes how we read the Bible and what we see and when we read it. Well, there is a certain appeal to keeping things short and sweet. Sometimes short is not always sweet, as we hear in this short sermon. So while he rightly identifies that love is powerful and it does change everything, but I think he does not do it justice by saying that love is only found in the New Testament with Jesus, and that the Old Testament is just filled with disasters and an angry God. Did you know, I found it a little surprising to learn, that the word love appears in the Old Testament 317 times. That is almost 100 times more than it appears in the New Testament 221 times. So in other words, the whole Bible is the story of God's love. And it can be reduced, summarized, celebrated in one word, love. How's that for a 1-second sermon? Sermon ended. But if I stopped there, I think you would be wanting more, because you know as well as I do that love is not that easy, just to say it, right? So love is hard to explain and understand, but it's even harder to practice and to live. So let's take a closer look. In the Old Testament, the Hebrew word hesed is translated as love. But it's not a romantic kind of love. It's a love of commitment. And it's not a love of feeling as much as it is a word of deeds. So in other words, it's love in action. So love is not just telling, but it's showing. So in the New Testament, there are many different Greek words. There's 7, actually, Greek words that are translated love. So there's many different nuances to this word love in the New Testament. So the one that's in our scripture lesson for today in the Gospel of John is agape. And agape love is love that is given by God. It is gracious. It is merciful, it is sacrificial, and it is ever-present. So in our lesson for today, Jesus tells about love. But in the whole Gospel of John, Jesus doesn't just tell about this agape love, he shows what it looks like. So at the Last Supper, Jesus broke bread and he poured wine to show what God's love looks like. gracious love that shares with others. After supper, Jesus got down on his knees and he washed his disciples' feet to show what God's love looks like. Merciful love that serves others. Jesus stretched out his arms on the cross and died to show what God's love looks like. Sacrificial love that gives its life. But before Jesus died, he promised his disciples. He promised that God would send the Holy Spirit to be for them an advocate, a companion, a comforter, a helper, a healer, a friend, to show what God's love looks like. Ever-present love to be with them however they needed it most. And so we see that Jesus tells his disciples and shows his disciples then and now what this agape love looks like. This love that is given by God, and also this love that we are called to share with one another. Agape love is gracious. It chooses to put another person's needs above our own. Agape love is merciful. It cares for others without expecting anything in return. Agape love is sacrificial. It pays it forward. It gives the shirt off its your own back. It's living simply so that others can simply live. Agape love is gracious and merciful and sacrificial, and it is ever present. It looks like a helper or a friend, someone who is with us always. And so you might be wondering, well, where is this love in the world today? When we look around and all we see is trouble and fear. Well, I was on the lookout this past week, and I was amazed at what I saw. I saw a whole lot of this love right here in our own church, our community, and in our country. Here's just a few that I saw this week. Today, love looks like the gracious people who have been decorating our sidewalk in front of the church with pictures and with words, blessings of love to encourage walkers. Today, love looks like the merciful masketeers, members of our church, women who have been sewing like crazy, and they have made hundreds of face masks that they have donated to our community near and far to help keep people safe from COVID-19. Today, love looks like the sacrificial gifts that our church has given this week, thousands of dollars, so that people can eat, can stay in their homes, pay their rent, pay their utilities, so they can survive. Today, love looks like the ever-present caregivers in hospitals that are healers and comforters to so many in need. One of those people, his name is Nick Brown, age 38, and he lives in a rural community in Ohio. and he came down with COVID-19 and was very sick. So he went into the Cleveland Clinic emergency room, and before long he was on a ventilator. And things did not look good. And so the hospital contacted his wife and said, we need to have a conversation about what we're going to do as his end of life approaches. Throughout the time he was in the hospital, the nurses and doctors wrote messages on the glass window of his room, messages to encourage him. And one of them said, we will get you home. So every day he saw these messages. And the messages helped. His spirit and the healing happened in his body. And so soon he was getting stronger. And then he was taken off the ventilator. And finally he got the good news that he was healed and that he could go home to his wife and to his two daughters. But before he left the hospital, he asked one of the nurses to help him write a message on that window, a message to be shared with all the nurses and doctors who helped him. And this is what he wrote. This window has been the most impactful window in my life. On days when I watched you work hard to keep me and others alive, I was unable to thank you for the time that you poured into me. And although I will probably never get the chance to pour that same love and support into you, I want you to know that I think you are all rock stars. After his discharge, he felt he got a second chance at life, and it was because of these caregivers. So he said, I don't know if I've ever seen such selfless people in my life. I really saw the love of God through these people. So here's my attempt at a 30-second sermon. For God so loved the world that God gave his only Son. Love is alive and well in the world today, even though it looks different. It's alive and well. So go, tell, and show what God's love looks like. Because love really does have the power to change the world, one hurting heart at a time. Amen.
This Sunday, we have another anthem from our archives. This is the chancel choir singing one of my favorite anthems that I've come across in our library, called To Love Our God. And it's in three sections. The first section, John Parker, who wrote the words, asks a few questions and ponders sort of the nature of life and the universe and some of the bigger questions. And in the second section, he continues to muse and try and work out this problem. And in the third one, he comes to the realization that really the most important thing that we can do, that we can think about, that we can offer is to love our God. So here is To Love Our God.
Thank you.
To love our God, we just heard the choir sing. So how do we love our God? In many different ways. And so in this time, we want to think about how we love our God with our heads, our hearts, and our hands. So first, our heads. If you'll join with me in reading the affirmation of faith that comes from a brief statement of faith. In life and in death, we belong to God. Through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, we trust in the one triune God, the Holy One of Israel, whom alone we worship and serve. We trust in Jesus, fully human, fully God. God raised this Jesus from the dead, breaking the power of sin and evil, delivering us from death to life eternal. With believers in every time and place, we rejoice that nothing in life or in death can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so we also love God with our hearts. And we open our hearts to God in prayer. And so this week, as I've been offering a different prayer practice for you to try at home, since we're spending a lot of time at home these days, here's a prayer practice for you to try at home. And that is, I would like you to try to focus on a different Greek word for love. Remember, I told you there's seven. We just talked about one today, agape, loving God and loving one another. But there is another one, it's philosia, and it means self-love. Now, that could get, if you take that to an extreme, that becomes narcissism. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about a healthy self-love, because we have to love ourselves first before we can love anyone else, right? So this week, I'm inviting you to just allow God to love you, because that's what God wants to do. So I invite you to sit for 5 minutes a day, just 5 minutes a day, longer if you'd like, but at least five, please, and just let God love you. Now, if that feels awkward to you, you're not sure what that means, I offer just one little phrase you can say over and over again. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on me. You can say that over and over again, out loud or in your mind, and then just allow God's love to fall afresh on you, to fill you to overflowing, and to remind you that you are a beloved child of God. So try that at home. And now together, let us unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on our world. People around the world could use a little love now. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on our country. People in our country could use a little love now. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on our community. People in our community could use a little love now. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on our church. People in our church family could use a little love now. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on us. We could all use a little love now. Spirit of the loving God, fall afresh on me. I could use a little love now. We pray these prayers and all the prayers of our hearts In the name of the one who came to show us love. Amen. And now for the Lord's Prayer. Since we talked about not just telling, but showing, I wanted to invite us to do an embodied Lord's Prayer. So I'm going to do some motions for each of the phrases. Feel free to repeat after me and do the motion I offer, or if you have one of your own, that's absolutely fine. But the idea is to not just speak, but to show what the prayer might look like. So let us pray. Our Father, and I'll ask Brian and Rebecca to repeat after me so I can hear the echo. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
On earth.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts. As we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation. But deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the glory.
Forever.
Amen. And so we love God with our heads, our hearts, and also our hands. And so one way that we love God with our hands is to be helpers in our church. And I want to announce now that thank you for joining us for the congregational meeting, either by Zoom or voting during the worship service. And I'm happy to admit, or to announce to you that all of the motions passed. Thank you for your votes, and we welcome all of our new servants, all the new people that have said yes to service, and I'm looking forward to serving with you. So congratulations and thank you and welcome. Another way that we use our hands, of course, is in giving. And so I invite you to think about how you might give in this coming week. And maybe it's a way that you can offer your time or talents or even your treasures. And so I want to invite you to think about that. And thank you if you are continuing to give to our church. Thank you. The ministry continues. And you allow us to continue doing God's work in this community. So thank you. If you are a member of another church and are just kind of visiting with us during this time when church buildings are closed and you might not have online worship, I invite you to continue giving to your home church. They could certainly use your support, but I welcome you to join us for worship. And if you don't want to give to a church, I invite you to give to a nonprofit, because there are plenty of them that could use your support in these days. One of those nonprofits that we support and that I want to lift up for today is to share with you the Mission and Outreach Committee that I talked about in my sermon, and trying to be a Matthew 25 church. This is what we did this week. We gave $5,000 to the North Hills Community Outreach. They're on the front line, helping people living in crisis, hardship and poverty, so that people can eat and pay their rent. We gave $1,000 to the 412 Food Rescue that goes to retailers and wholesalers to prevent surplus food from going bad, rescues that food and brings it back, and then gives it to people that are in need. We gave $750 to the Bellevue Farmers Market, which provides meals to the local community members. And then $750 to the North Boroughs Meals on Wheels, which gives free meals to seniors in our community. And that left, and we have a little extra left, about $100, that we're starting a new COVID-19 fund, and we'll probably come up with a better name for this. But the idea is that if you want to donate directly to this fund, then we'll make sure that those monies are given directly to helping relief efforts during this pandemic. So you can let us know how, if you'd like to do that, and we'll make sure it goes to the right place. So for all of these different ways that we can use our hands in giving and helping and showing God's love in this world, we give thanks. And so with thanks to God for all of the blessings that God gives to us, let us now take just a moment, and then we will sing our doxology to take a moment and think how we might give back to God and to God's world this week.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Christ, all people hear below. Praise Holy Spirit evermore. Praise Triune God,
having given these gifts to God, let us dedicate them in prayer. Let us pray. Gracious God, in response to the gift of your amazing grace and eternal love, we offer ourselves to you. Open our minds to learn and grow. Open our hearts to share our love. Open our hands to help others in need. Bless our humble offerings. Make them holy reflections of you. We pray in the name of Jesus, the risen Christ. Amen. Thank you. friends, let us go into this week. Go and claim the love that called you. Go and live the truth that has found you. Go and rest in the peace that is given to you, remembering that God is with you now and always. So may God bless you and keep you. May God be gracious to you. May God look upon you with favor and give you peace this day and forevermore. Amen.
God be with you till we meet again. Loving counsels guide and uphold you with a shepherd caring for you. God be with you till we meet again.
Friends, God be with you until we meet again, praying that is sooner rather than later. But God be with you now and always. Now, friends, let us share a piece of Christ with whoever you can share it with. So wherever you are, let's pass the peace of Christ. The peace of Christ be with you. And then stay tuned for a video of passing of the peace and also for a grand amen that you're going to want to see. Peace of Christ be with you.
I'm also with you.
Peace be with you.
Bring peace.
Peace be with you till we meet again.
Peace be with you. And you, Spot, too.
Good morning. Sharing peace.
Sharing peace.
Peace be with you.
I'm going to teach you a new word today. Will you repeat after me and say? In English, the word is peace.
Peace.
In Spanish, the word is paz.
Paz.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
Amen. 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 Amen.